didn't really even want to do one, but I just figured there's a rare occasion. My son, who, he's actually another anomaly because he grew up, literally, my mother was diagnosed when he was a newborn, so we really found out. We found out about her illness. What?
Is it not recording, is it?
Okay, 1 second. Oh my gosh, technical difficulties. Okay. So, we're going to recap because we just lost connection. I have a rare occasion where my son is going to do the podcast. He's going to answer a few questions. And he actually grew up with the disease. He was a newborn when my mother was diagnosed, which he has a different perspective. Even I don't know how it was with your grandmother being diagnosed with Alzheimer's and you growing up with it. How was it? And Karen is here. Do your little intro.
Hello.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. All right. Okay. So. Well, so Karen's going to ask him questions because she wants to know.
Right. So so I noticed that my mom is getting worse. And when my mom gets upset, she's one of the many folks with Alzheimer's who likes to bolt. She gets frustrated and she wants to go home, never recognizing where she is. And she could be very far from home, having no sense of how to get home, but she wants to kind of run out the door. And so we've registered her with the police department here in Peel as a vulnerable person, and she has a tracking device bracelet on her arm. So I was telling Karen that it was a very difficult week.
And sorry, to recap, your mom has had Alzheimer's diagnosed for 3 years?
I think it's actually 4 years.
Okay, 4 years. Okay, so it's like early onset?
Like your mom, she's an early onsetter. And I was telling Karen that it was a really rough week seeing my mom trying to run out of my house. And I now recognize that the illness is progressing. And I was talking to Karen and had a brief conversation with Jalen because I want to make sure that I am doing right by my children. And they know all about the disease. My daughter's doing a project, my 10-year-old on Alzheimer's. She's doing a speech next year. She's reading Karen's book as part of her research, so she's really excited about that. But it would be really helpful to get another young person's perspective on having a grandmother with Alzheimer's. And I recognize that Jalen was very young. Obviously, he was a newborn. And so his perspective is very different than that of my children, because my children will have memories of their mom, of their grandmother, without being symptomatic of the disease. And there's Coco the dog.
Yeah, okay.
So yeah, Jalen, I just, if you want to share what it has been like, that would be really helpful for me.
Yeah, because I never really got to know my grandmother before she was diagnosed. It's as if, like, it's just a patient downstairs. Mm-hmm. It's not really a family member. And it's hard to say, but it's hard to really connect. Even though I know she's blood, it's hard to, you know, because I can't hug her every day. I can't always hold her and everything because she has the disease. So, yeah, it's a bit hard.
You know what? I don't know if I had anticipated your response.
I know, me neither. That's the first time he's ever said something like that.
So, honestly, I appreciate your honesty and your candor.
Wow.
Yeah.
Didn't expect that.
That it's been hard.
It's back, yeah.
Okay, so I was just telling Jalen that I, you know, Karen and I are sitting here with tears in our eyes because we're parents, and I just appreciate his candor and his honesty. And I know from everything that... that your mom has always said that your grandmother was so looking forward to meeting you when you were in utero. And so I know that she loved you before she even met you. So,
how does it feel now? Like, okay, she's like a patient, right? Because you don't have that connection, which is understandable, right? But you don't remember in the early times, well, you see it in pictures, like she would never put you down.
Yeah.
Like she wouldn't want to be separated from him. So does that help you with your memory? Do you remember any of that?
I mean,
like, no. Do you remember watching The Wiggles with her? Or Barney?
I don't, but I can picture it.
Okay.
So it does help, because then I'm able to see that, yeah, this is really somebody who really cared for me, but not having the memories is kind of hard.
That's why, like, he hates it, right? But I force him to take these pictures now. I'm like, you know what I'm doing, right? But because if he didn't even have those pictures, he doesn't have that recollection,
right,
of that connection. So at least he can, you can kind of put it together, because all of them, she's holding you.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
yes.
You know, his grandfather would be like, you're spoiling the child, like, right? But yeah, that was her connection with him. She was very close with him. But it's good to know.
Mm-hmm.
So what advice would you give now what you know? And I know it's different because it's different, but what advice?
Especially, you know, the fact that your grandmother is aging in the home, right? And so she's here,
mm-hmm.
and, you know, supports are needed to help provide really great care. And so that's something that impacts you directly, because your home is also now open to great staff who come in and help your mom take care of your grandmother. And so what are you?
Yeah, it's sort of common now. I don't really see it as an abnormality.
Right.
It seems like normal to have people come in and help around the house. So I'm really used to it. And
we're like immune, I think.
Yeah.
But can you remember, I'm sorry I'm cutting, but I'm just, because
okay.
I'm remembering. I remember he used to want to have sleepovers,
mm-hmm.
and that used to be a big deal. So he has had to make sacrifices, because I used to be like, you know, I'm not.
Like, you go to a friend's house and they're allowed to be as loud as they want, or they're allowed to sort of have their guests over in different spots of the house, when you can't do that. Because I know if I had one of my friends, even if they saw what my grandmother's, how she is down there, like, the friendship wouldn't be the same, because they'd probably have pity or something over me, and that's not something I want.
Yeah, that's the whole thing, and I said that too, and you don't want sympathy. Like, this is not what this is. You don't want people to feel sorry for you.
Mm-hmm.
You just want them to understand
and show some compassion.
And compassion, and then, and not treat you any different. Just kind of like, just be compassionate and empathetic. That's it. And I don't even know if you remember, because Grandma was upstairs for a long time. Do you remember that?
Oh, no, I don't.
See, like, she used to be right next door to you in the other room, so... Even that, like, it's a lot of transitions that he's had to go through growing up with this disease, but you have a different perspective. Is that why you want to do neurology?
Yeah, that's a large part of why, because it's hard to, like, believe that what your brain is really who you are. Like, it controls so much of how you act and how you behave as a person, and just any little thing that goes wrong with it can affect more than just you, but everyone around you. So I really want to be able to understand what's going on.
I think that's wonderful.
So there's a silver lining, the blessing, right?
Yeah.
Maybe you'll cure Alzheimer's.
That would be lovely.
That's a dream, yeah.
Yeah, that's
yeah,
a great
that's
dream.
My dream.
That's a great dream.
So we should probably end on that great note.
Yeah, that's a great note to end.
Thank you.
No
thanks.
Problem.
I know you hate this,
no,
so this is like a rare occasion. And thanks for making me cry. It was great.
And making me cry as well.
It wasn't as bad as I thought it would be.
See? And people want to know, people. Like, there's
yeah.
a lot of people who are struggling as well when explaining to...
And I'm that person.
Right. Explaining what the disease causes, how it is, the patience that you have to have. And I have to say I am blessed because Jalen's very understanding. He wasn't a difficult child, you know, in terms of, that's a lot, like having your house open to where we're so immune. It's like,
yeah.
Like we're just like, we're like, oh, it's just the nurse. Oh, it's a PSW. Like it's just like pass the coffee, like it's like nothing, right? And it's difficult. It's difficult growing up with it. And he literally has from day one. So you're like, should we call Guinness?
it doesn't feel like that big of an accomplishment.
Well, wow. It's 17 and a half years.
It's just, you do what you have to, right?
Wonder where you got that from. No, but okay, seriously though, another note too, Christmas is always very difficult because we're always praying that it doesn't happen around this time because it's already hard enough, her not kind of being here. She's here, but you know what I mean? Like,
absolutely.
And we're always like, please not, like, let's not let it happen now, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we're counting our blessings that it's been 2 years in palliative, right? And hopefully she makes it through this holiday season and we don't have any sad news more than it already is sad, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Okay, so Jalen, it's time for the mama smile. There you go. Mommy's smiling too.
Okay.
So we want to wish everybody happy holidays.
Yes, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
And we wish you all the best for the season.
Mm.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yep, yeah.
Okay. Bye, everybody.
Bye. Okay, you press the button because every time it's so unfortunate.